tentative that this is not.
Mm-hmm. But you let us know, yes or no. Vote now using GMA on your smartphones. George?
You're going to watch that tally. Thank you, guys. I'm here with Katie Couric. She's with us this morning to talk about one of her passions, preventing cancer. You're going to see Katie on the cover right there, this month's Prevention Magazine, because it's National Colorectal Cancer Awareness Month.
That's a mouthful.
And Katie, yeah, it sure is. But I got it out. Second leading cancer killer in the country.
That's right, of men and women. And women are diagnosed as often as men, George. So it's one of these cancers that is highly preventable, and that's why we're focusing.
And that's what you're talking about, because you say it all the time, you've got to go for that screening.
Yeah, this is something I've been relentless about ever since my husband, Jay Monahan, died of colorectal cancer back in 1998. He was just 42 years old at the time. But George, despite my nonstop nagging, 40% of the people who should be getting screened are not. So we need to put this message out over and over again, because it saves lives. And while it might not be at the top of anyone's to-do list, I guarantee you it is a lot better than being diagnosed with colorectal cancer. Now, I first did a colonoscopy on TV. Many of you might remember that a few years ago. And I was due to have another one. So I forced my friend Kim, who had just turned 50, to do a hers and hers colonoscopy. And it started with romantic drinks for two at my kitchen table.
Let's get it started.
Good stuff.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Bottoms up.
We got a million of them.
Good, a little tired.
Great news, everything's perfect. I did find a few things though, I was surprised. And one thing was this duster. I don't know what this was doing there. Batman was in there. And then the last thing, I don't know what this is, lipstick?
Oh, lipstick. I've been looking everywhere for that lipstick.
You're good, everything went really well.
So the bottom line, so to speak, is not that bad. I had a nice little nap this morning, and the best news of all, I found Batman.
Oh, you know, we try to have a little fun with this, George. At least they didn't find my head up there, right? meanwhile, you know, in all seriousness, it turned out to be a very good thing that I brought my friend Kim with me, because as I said, she had just turned 50 and she had a 2 centimeter, the size of a large olive, tubular advanced adenoma, which is a polyp, a flat one, and it was removed during the procedure, thank goodness, but her doctor, Felicia Nall, said it could have created really significant problems for her in the future if she hadn't had it removed. So I always tell Kim, see, I saved
her
life.
You helped her out. That's right.
Because she wanted to cancel on me.
But 50 is that magic number. You turn 50, you're supposed to get a test, but some people, maybe even earlier, depending on their family
well,
history.
Well, you know, 13,000 people under the age of 50 are diagnosed with colorectal cancer every year. So if you have any symptoms or a family history, you should get it 10 years prior to the onset of that diagnosis for a first-line relative. But if you're in your 40s and you have some symptoms, like looking back on it, Jay had unexplained weight loss. His stomach wasn't feeling well. He always sort of had a sour stomach and always had Tums or Rolaids in his pocket. But, you know, if you have rectal bleeding or blood in your stools, you really need to talk to a doctor. But we should point out that this is a silent killer, and oftentimes there are no symptoms whatsoever.
And so many people put off the testing because, you know, you guys made fun of it, but it's not fun.
Well, you know, the prep is worse than the procedure. I mean, but I always think of it as a cleansing colonic, you know, and if you put it that way, it's a lot
you know, more comfortable than being diagnosed with full-out colorectal cancer, which is, I can tell you from personal experience, a nightmare.
Oh, and you gave me a tip for the next time. That ginger ale might help.
Yeah, the diet ginger ale isn't bad, and you can suck on lifesavers before you down it as well.
Cost a big factor for a lot of people.
Yeah, you know, 33 states now mandate that insurance companies cover colon cancer screening, most often colonoscopy. And now the CDC and local health departments can also help people who are uninsured by providing low-cost or no-cost colonoscopy or other kinds of screening. So that's really good news. So there's no excuse. You really can get this
and
done.
You get it once. It can last for some time. The screen lasts for some
usually
time.
I think it's up to the doctor's discretion. If you have a polyp, you often have to do it 3 to 5 years after that. But if you're polyp-free, you can wait a decade. What? Because colon cancer is very slow growing.
And you have so much help getting this message out.
Yeah, that's right. Diane Keaton did a public service announcement for us because her grandmother, Granny Keaton, died of colorectal cancer. Terrence Howard also did one for us because his mom, by the way, this is prevalent in the African American community, and some people suggest 45 as the beginning of screening for black folks because they have a much higher incidence and mortality rate. And now I'm really excited because Meryl Streep is going to do our next PSA. So
newest
we've
Oscar
got an
winner.
Academy Award winner telling everyone to get screened.
That is great. You're going to be talking on Google Plus at 9 o'clock today. We're going to be right back, though, with George Clooney in an epic ping pong match. Susan Sarandon up against Josh and Sam.